Today's question, could the Hyperloop really kill you? The Hyperloop seems to have picked up some speed lately, so it's important to consider how safe it would be. A YouTuber by the name of Thunderfoot has made 7 videos explaining why the Hyperloop is a bad idea. I'm glad he's doing this because we should always have a healthy amount of skepticism when it comes to new technology. But there are some problems with his arguments. Don't get me wrong, Thunderfoot brings up a lot of good concerns, but every one of these problems has a solution. Let's start with his first video, titled How the Hyperloop Can Kill You.
So I'm making my next Patreon-supported video, which is going to be Busting the Hyperloop, a project that might be better described as all the problems of space travel while traveling in a gun barrel at nearly the speed of sound.
First, I want to point out that the hardest part about space travel is getting the rocket to space. Astronauts are strapped into what is essentially a bomb that consists of 90% rocket fuel, and somehow the other 10% has to maintain a controlled explosion to get the thing into space. This is a really difficult task, but the beauty of tube travel is that you aren't strapped into a bomb because there's no fuel to cause an explosion. But my main concern with Thunderfoot's video was his experiment.
Okay, so there's a little metal ball in my mini Hyperloop.
Luckily, this is not what would happen in a real Hyperloop breach. First of all, Thunderfoot's steel ball was about the same size as the inside of the glass tube. That means that not much air could escape around the edges of the ball. In a real Hyperloop, pods would probably have much more space around them to let air through. Second, let's think about what would happen if we made this ball 300 times bigger in diameter. The mass of the ball scales with the cube of diameter, so it becomes 27 million times heavier. But the force on the ball, which is proportional to its surface area, only scales with the square of diameter, so it increases by a factor of only 90,000. Since acceleration is equal to force divided by mass, the larger ball would experience 300 times less acceleration than what you saw in Thunderfoot's video. Now, the math I'm doing is only a rough estimate, but it should give you an idea of how different this experiment is from a real Hyperloop. Finally, I want to point out that this experiment did not consider any countermeasures. In a real Hyperloop, pods could control their deceleration by using a propulsion system, deploying emergency brakes, and readmitting air into the system. Now, before you go, don't forget to leave a comment letting me know what you'd like to see in future videos. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time on Tube Travel.